So first exercise, first day, first question. Anyone have doubt? We have completed that one. Anyone have doubt? Second one. Second question, were you able to solve? Second question, any doubt? If you have doubt, either raise your hand or unmute and tell. Second question, it is very easy question. Yes. Yes, Kushi, were you able to solve the second one?
No, sir.
Okay. So we start with second. Okay, second is very easy. X square plus y square minus y. X minus root of x square minus y square. Divided by, okay, divide, I'm removing. Okay. Divide, I'm straightforward, remove. With multiplication sign. So, let's hope that we have to write. X square, here it is, x square. Plus y square plus y divided by root of x square minus y square plus x. Okay.
Sir?
Yes.
Sir, in question, there is division of both the sides.
There is division, see what I did. There was division, so I did the reciprocal of that. See the question, how? Made the numerator as denominator, denominator as numerator. Therefore, I can use multiplication. Understood that one? Understood?
Yes, sir.
Now, you can solve. See here. A minus B. Okay, we can rewrite it. Yes. X square plus y square minus y. Divided by x minus root of x square minus y square. Multiply. Root of x square plus y, and here I can interchange the terms x plus root of x square minus y square. Can you see a minus b, a plus b, denominator as well? Any doubt with that? So now just a plus b into a minus b we have to do. A square minus B square. So what it will be there? X square A plus B. This whole we are taking as A. And this is B. Here this will be A. This will be B. Understood this one? Always check for this one. This is the most loved equation. Or most loved identity. So always check. Always remember this identity can be applied anywhere. Okay. So, let's give it in this form. We can write x square plus y square. Root cancelled. Root cancelled. Because root of x square plus y square the whole square. Okay, I write that as well. Minus y square. Similarly, denominator. X square minus root of x square minus y square. The whole square. Any doubt, if you face any doubt, to ask immediately. Don't ask after completion of the question or rubbing the question. Okay. So it will be x square plus y square, x square minus x square. 1 minute. X square minus x square plus y square. Okay. We go very fast. Y square minus y square is 0. X square minus x square is 0. X upon y, the whole square, or x square upon y square, we got the answer. Understood this one? Third one, you have to do it yourself. Yes? Third one, you have to do it yourself. It's just the, you have to rationalize the denominator. You have to rationalize the denominator. Rest, you can put the answer. For example, in third, you are getting root 20, and if you get root 20, how you can write this as root of 4 into 5, 2 root 5. So you can put the value of root 5. Understood this one? Root 20 is nothing but 2 root 5. So root 5 value you can put and solve. Okay, third one, do it yourself. Fourth one, start doing. Okay, fourth one, solve first one. So all everyone in your notebook. Fourth one, x is given. Now you have to calculate x plus 1 by x. Calculate that one. X plus 1 by x. Now everyone do calculate it. Start doing it in what we don't know. Take the pen and the notebook and start. X equal to root 3 minus root 2. And first you have to find this is our x. X plus 1 by x. Start calculating everyone in your notebook. X plus 1 by x you have to find. Find the value and tell. Ayushi, keep do it and tell the answer. What will be the value of x plus 1 by x? Ayushi, teacher. This is our x. Plus. Or you can we can calculate first 1 upon x we can calculate separately. We can calculate 1 upon x separately. Or you can calculate it as 1 upon root 3 minus root 2. Ayushi, what will be the next step? 1 upon x we have written. Ayushi? Azim, you tell, Abdul Azim, what will be the next step? What will be the next step? Abrar. Unmute yourself and tell. Abrar. Arindam. What will be next step? Is denominator a rational number? No? So we have to rationalize the denominator. 1 upon root 3 minus root 2 into root 3 plus root 2 divided by root 3 plus root 2. So how much we are getting? Root 3 plus root 2 divided by 3 minus 2, that is root 3 plus root 2. This is our 1 upon x. And you have to calculate x plus 1 upon x. How much it will be? Root 3 minus root 2 plus root 3 plus root 2. Root 2 get cancelled. How much you are getting? So, x plus 1 upon x equal to 2 root 3. We got x value. Understood this one? Okay, x square plus 1 upon x square, you have to calculate next. Do it in your notebook. You have 1 minute. So, which identity are you going to use? You have to calculate x square plus 1 upon x square. One way is calculate x square, calculate 1 upon x square, then add that. Okay? There is some other method as well, very easy method. You know it, a plus b the whole square, x plus 1 upon x the whole square. How much we are getting? X square plus 1 upon x square plus 2ab, 2x into 1 upon x, x and x get cancelled plus 2. So value of x square plus 1 upon x square will be how much? 2 will take on this side. X plus 1 upon x the whole square. Minus 2. So x plus 1 upon x, we already have the value. Put the value here. Take the square, subtract 2 from that. Understood this one? Any doubt in this? So how much you are getting? 2 root 3, the whole square, minus 2. It will be how much? 4 3 is 12 minus 2. So, how much you got answer? 10? Now x cube plus 1 upon x cube. Okay, before that you must remember one identity. A plus b the whole cube. What its value? A plus b the whole cube. You have to remember this identity. So either you can solve it like this. If you don't remember a square, that is a plus b the whole square into a plus b plus 2ab and again multiply with a plus b. You can solve this identity. Or if you remember a plus b the whole cube equal to a cube plus b cube plus 3, anybody class you remember 3ab a plus b. This is the identity. We will be discussing these identities in expansions. A chapter is there that is devoted to these identities. Okay. This you understood, a plus b the whole cube equal to a cube plus b cube plus 3ab into a plus b into a plus b. Do write this equation. Okay. In book as well, write this equation below. Space is given. Here, so the space is given, you can write the equation here so you will remember this equation. A plus b the whole cube. Okay. Now, if I replace a with x and b with 1 upon x, whole cube. Okay. So, how much will we get? X cube plus 1 upon x cube. Its value we have to calculate. Plus 3 x into 1 by x. Cancelled, remaining x plus 1 by x. Okay. And whose value we have to calculate? X cube plus 1 upon x cube. Its value we have to calculate. Okay. Solve it now. How are we going to start solving? So, x plus 1 upon x value we have. X plus 1 upon x value we have. So, take that on left hand side. Okay, solve it. You have 1 minute. Solve it fast, everyone, your notebook. Write the further steps. So, next step, write it. How do you solve this one? I will put down this one. It will be x cube plus 1 upon x cube equal to x plus 1 upon x all cube minus 3 x plus 1 upon x. Just put the value. X plus 1 upon x whole cube, how much? It's cube we have to take. Take the cube minus 3 times 2 root 3. Solve it yourself. Okay, next one. Next one is very easy. X cube plus 1 upon x cube minus 3 x square plus 1 upon x square plus x plus 1 upon x. Now see here, we have already calculated the value of x 2 plus 1 upon x. Just put the value here, minus 3 times its value as well we have calculated, plus x plus 1 upon x value as well we have calculated. Just put it here and solve, you will get the answer. Okay, solve it. Solve third and fourth. Fourth question, third and fourth part. Solve it, everyone. In the equation, it's just we have to put the values. You have to just put the values. You have 1 minute, solve it fast. Anyone who understood or is not able to solve these two? Anyone in class?
Completed,
that's good. Anyone in class who haven't understood or is not able to solve these two? Check the answers. Check your answer. Its answer you will be getting 18 root 3. Its answer you will be getting 18 root 3. And 4 fold. How much will we get there? Then, to okay, check from back, you can check it. That's correct answer. Solve these two. Okay. Okay, fifth one we discuss. Negative of a rational number is irrational. Negative of a irrational number is irrational. Is it true or false? If we are taking any rational number, root 5 we have given. It's negative, it's irrational. Irrational number. If I take negative of this one, is it irrational number? Is it irrational number?
Yes, sir.
The answer is true. It's a irrational number. Root 5, irrational. Minus root 5 also, the product of a known zero rational number and an irrational number is rational number. Is it true? Product of the rational number. It's true or false?
Sir, false.
It's false. You can see as well, product of a known zero rational number. Any known non-zero rational number we can. This is rational number, product of multiplication with any irrational number, take any number, root 2, root 5, root 3, root 3, it is 2 root 3, it's irrational. So, fifth second is false. Okay, sixth one, draw a line segment of length root 3.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, can you solve the fourth, third part?
Fourth, third part. Okay, you tell me. Have you understood this step?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now what you have to do? How much is x plus 1 upon x?
2 root 3.
Okay, now what you have to do? It's cube we have to take, cube, minus 3, x plus 1 upon x, 3 into 2 root 3. How much should we get it? 2 cube is how much? 8, root 3 cube, root 3 into 3 root 3, minus 6 root 3. 8 3 is a 24 root 3 minus 6 root 3. Okay. Now see root 3. Root 3 common we can take 24 minus 6. How much you are getting? 18 root 3. How do you want the answer?
Okay, sir. Thank
you. Question is where were you till now? We are discussing this. Why you want to ask earlier? I have told whenever the doubt arises, ask. Don't wait and don't think much. Okay, this is clear. Similarly, you can do this one. Okay, this you have to try. If you don't get it, ask tomorrow. Okay, fifth one. Draw a line segment of length root 3. This we have drawn. So I'm noting the rational number line. How we have drawn? For example, root 2 we have drawn. How we have drawn root 2? In a triangle, if we draw 1 unit at 90 degree, it's a right angle triangle, join them. What will be its hypotenuse? Will be root 2? Okay. If you again
So we can take the base is 2 and height is 1. So then
that is given in your book. If you take base as 2 and height as 1, 2 and 1, okay? So what will be the hypotenuse?
Root 5.
Root 5? Okay.
But two what square and plus 3 square.
What you have to draw? Root 6. Okay. In book, that's different way. So this way we have constructed, we use this one. Okay. 1 centimeter, 1 centimeter, hypotenuse root 2. Root 2 we got. Now at this point, draw a perpendicular of 1 unit. Again 1 unit. Okay. Join that. How much will be this hypotenuse? So root 2 square plus 1 square. It's 4 root. It is how much? 2 plus 1 root. Root 3. So we are getting root 3. Understood this one? This we have drawn. Okay. This one, draw it yourself. Draw a line segment of root of length root 8. Okay, anyone in class? How we are going to do that? How we are going to draw that root 8 length? Root of 8. How are we going to draw that? Can you simplify it? Can root 8 be simplified? Can we write in some other form? What is root? 8. 8, factorize 8. Factorize 8. Factorize 8. 8 can be done as 2 into 2 into 2. Now, if pairing we have, we can take 1 2 out, 2 root 2. Root 8 can be written as 2 root 2. Root 8 can be written as 2 root 2. Okay. See here, these questions will get more clear. Okay, rational number we don't have. Okay. Last year, you already have studied squares and square roots. How to take the square roots? So, root 8 can be written as 2 root 2. Okay. That means we have to draw root 2. Then it's double layer to take. Understood this one? So, this is 0, this is 1. Okay. Same length, perpendicular we draw. Okay. Now, if we join them, what we are going to get? Root 2. Okay. Now, in your compass, okay, what we did next? Measure this length and make an arc from this tip, make an arc. So this length will be how much? Root 2 from here to here. From here to here, this length is how much? Root 2. Okay. Now, same length in your compass. Don't change the radius. Put it here and mark here. This length is how much? Root 2. And total length is how much? Root 2 plus root 2? 2 root. Understood this one?
Sir, can you repeat?
Okay. Were you able to draw room 2? Were you able to draw room 2? Okay. See here what you have to draw. We have to draw room 2. So that means we will draw first room 2. And then if you take the double of that one, you get 2 room 2. And that will be what? Root 8. Okay. So how we are going to draw? Draw the number 9. Mark 0. Mark 1. Okay. 1 I am taking here. Some length. 1 we have taken. Okay. And how we draw? Draw perpendicular at 1. This length and this length must be same. This length, whatever you have taken as 1 unit, this must be same. So if this is this much. So here, okay. This length and this length must be same. Okay. Now, this is one unit, this is also one unit. If we draw that, what we are getting? We are getting a right angle triangle. Which kind of right angle? Isosceles, right angle triangle, because both sides are equal, these two sides. And what will be the value of this side? What will be the value of this side? Root 2. Hypotenuse value will be root 2, that we already discussed. Okay, I think we are not revising. Students, you have to revise well. Okay, we go root 2. Now, in your compass, the sharp tip, put it here, pencil tip, put it here. Measure the distance and draw the arc. So, from here, we are drawing the arc. Okay, draw the arc. Arc. So this length is how much? Till this one. This is root 2 length. And how much we should have? 2 root 2, double of this one. So same length, don't change the radius in the compass. It's of radius is how much root 2. Put here and make an arc again. So this is how much this length? Root 2. Total length is how much? 2 root 2. So this is our 2 root, or we can say it is root 8. Understood? Everyone have understood this one?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Start revising. You have to revise them all. Okay, show that this is equal to 52 upon 11. Okay, can 8 question do as on one? How you are going to do that one? Each term, rationalize it. So one term I am giving example, 4 minus root 5 divided by 4 plus root 5. This is the first term. Rationalize it. How you are going to rationalize? By what we should multiply? 4. This we have to rationalize. 4 minus root 5. 4 minus root 5. So this one, how much you are getting? 4 minus root 5, the whole square. 16 minus 5, 11. Okay. Similarly, to the second term. Rationalize second term. Similarly, to the third one. Third term. And you will get the answer. Okay. 4, 8 question, do his homework. Okay. 9th, first, second, third. Again, try his homework. Okay. It is same as fourth question. We have discussed fourth question as well, it is same as in last exercise as well. So 8th and 9th, try to do as homework. Okay. X you have to get, x is given, x cube plus 1 upon x square, you have to calculate. So x is given, 1 upon x you will calculate, x plus 1 upon x you will calculate, and using the same equation that we are using fourth, third, you can solve. Second, x square plus 1 upon x square is given. That you have to show x is given. Again, same as fourth, second. Third one, rationalize each term's denominator and you will get the answer. Now show that this one. 10th question. You have to show them that they are irrational. X is irrational. X square is how much? 6. X will be how much? Root 6. X will be how much? Root 2, root 3. So, we already know root 2 is irrational, root 3 is irrational. So, product of irrational and irrational number gives?
X is equal to 6, root of 6. Okay.
It is as well irrational. Here it is irrational. Okay. Root 2 into root 3 by getting root 6. It is irrational. Okay. Next one, x square. Or you can do it this way as well. Root of 2 into 3.
Okay, second one.
X is equal to 0.009. X equal to root of 9 upon 1000. X equal to 3 we can take. Here by 10 we have to take 10 root 10. So root 10 is an irrational number. Therefore, X is an irrational number. You can say. Here you can simply say here root 6 is an irrational number. Here as well, root 10 is an irrational number. Because 6 is not a perfect square, therefore its root will be a irrational number. Here, 10 is not a perfect square, therefore its root will be a irrational number, and this makes the whole term as irrational.
Okay, next one, x root.
X square equal to 27. Root of equal to 27. X equal to what? Take root of 27. 3 into 3 into 3. X equal to 3 root 3. So root 3 is an irrational number, and therefore 3 into root 3 is an irrational number. But integration of rational and irrational is irrational here.
Okay, show that X is a rational number. Similarly, you can show this one.
X equal to 16. X equal to root of 16. 16 is a perfect square, X equal to 4. 4 is a rational number.
Similarly, second and third you can solve. Okay, you can show. Using the following figure, show that BD equal to root x. Okay, 12th we discuss tomorrow in class. Okay, so tomorrow, complete this exercise. If you have doubt, ask tomorrow. Okay, complete this exercise.
Okay, sir. If
doubt, ask tomorrow. Okay, and we start another chapter. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.